There seems to be a big push for local phones to have a premium looks lately. So, not to be outdone by the competition, Kata launched the Kata i4 smartphone. If you haven't heard of it, now is the perfect time to get acquainted with it. In case you need to brush up on your Kata i4 specs knowledge, here's what you need to know. It sports a 5-inch HD touchscreen display, 16-megapixel rear camera, and 8-megapixel front cam combo. And it runs on a 1.7 GHz octa-core processor. Storage is inbuilt, as is the battery, but it appears to be an all-around interesting phone. Let's start by examining the design. The Kata i4 caught me by surprise when I took it out of its box, and the reason why is because it may actually be the first phone I've seen from any local company that look almost exactly like the phone depicted on the front of the retail box. When I finally held the Kata i4 in my hands, there was no denying it. It actually feels solid and nice, and also it's not slippery. It's made with metal where you're supposed to grip it, and it feels reassuring. The cool solid metal is a great contrast to the finicky plastic build materials found in most local phones and tablets. There's a power button on the right side of the Kata, and a volume rocker is found on the left side. The front of the phone contains only the display, front camera, and capacitive menu buttons. Meanwhile, the back is where you'll find the main camera, built-in speaker, and the familiar Kata branding. The overall look and feel of the phone is definitely premium and even luxurious. Again, this is a sight to behold, especially if you're fed up with seeing seemingly low-quality plastic build alternatives from other smartphone companies. Let's talk about the display and camera. We've gone over how the physical attributes of the Kata can be worthy of note, but what about its other components? Well, the 5-inch HD display is not a major disappointment. First off, the HD resolution is acceptable on a 5-inch device, and from our testing, we see no real problems with it when it comes to viewing angles. I've been able to use it for web browsing, reading text, watching movies, and mobile games. Suffice it to say that the Kata offers satisfactory display performance for most Android users and will not disappoint. The cameras on the Kata i4, meanwhile, are a bit of a mixed bag. As I've said near the beginning of this review, the rear camera packs a 16-megapixel sensor, while the front cam relies on an 8-megapixel sensor. The actual performance of either camera depends heavily on the amount of ambient light available. Using the front camera indoors is almost impossible. Meanwhile, the rear cam only really works to its full potential outdoors, or wherever there's loads of available lighting on subjects for photos. The long and short of it is, the Kata i4 works as a camera phone, but don't expect it to deliver stellar results, much less replace any dedicated point-and-shoot camera anytime soon. The camera app might have something to do with it, in which case you will be free to replace it with whichever camera app that you want if you can download and install it. For audio and connectivity, audio performance on the Kata i4 is unsurprisingly satisfactory. We weren't expecting mind-blowing sounds, but the phone did manage to serve us well both as a music player as well as a video playback device. Audio for games works well too. There's a built-in 3.5 headphone jack at the top of the phone, and I'm happy to report that it didn't give me any compatibility problems no matter what type of headphones I use with it. And of course, you can also just use Bluetooth if you rather connect to a wireless speaker you might have. Speaking of connectivity, the only other port on the Kata i4 is the micro USB 2.0 port located at the bottom, near the pinhole mic for phone calls. This USB port can be used for both charging as well as data transfer. Let's talk about the software and performance. Although I've said plenty about the Kata i4 so far, since I'm talking mostly about its hardware, I'm afraid that I couldn't able to talk as much about it when it comes to software. The reason for this is because the Kata i4 is stuck on Android 4.4 KitKat as its default OS. Now that the latest version of Android is literally more than two whole numbers ahead, that's more than a little disappointing. With that said, the Kata i4 still makes everything work well despite the dated OS. It has an app drawer, so all of its installed apps are organized alphabetically. And the home screen can be customized to your liking by changing the wallpaper or adding your own favorite widgets. With its speedy octa-core processor, the Kata i4 has no problem running Android 4.4 KitKat. This is to be expected out of any octa-core phone, really, so there's nothing surprising here. So what's surprising is that Kata i4 only has a little over 22 gigs of space available for user storage. Even though it comes with 32 gigs of internal storage, the Kata i4 doesn't have room for a bundled micro SD card. So that much internal storage should be a good thing. However, almost 6GB of it goes to internal storage where all the phone's apps are. Only the 22GB or so left can be used for actual storage on the phone itself. None of this affects the overall performance, of course, but it's something that needs to be noted, especially for those people who buy phones primarily for their mass storage function. Speaking of overall performance, the Kata i4 works wonderfully well as a phone, as a mobile entertainment and gaming device, and an internet device. There is no lag when it comes to navigating the apps and menu screens, and it doesn't freeze even with heavy multitasking. For the battery life, all of that is well and good, but how is the battery life on the Kata i4? Thankfully, it's not disappointing unlike the storage situation. The built-in battery on the Kata i4 easily managed to last for an entire day as a main phone, running all of our favorite apps and connected to Wi-Fi for pretty much the entire day. When used with mobile data, battery life drops a bit, but not too much. This is a phone you can rely on to get you through your daily commute. With light normal use, it should last about 2 days before getting run down to less than 15%. So in conclusion, the Kata i4 is about the closest thing to a diamond in the rough that you will be able to find in the local smartphone market. Assuming I'm not using that old expression wrong, it looks absolutely stunning. The build quality is perfect in all the right places, the battery life is dependable, and the overall performance makes this a phone for your daily grind. It's a shame that some of the other features are a bit disappointing, like the dated software and limited storage space. If you can somehow overlook these minor flaws, the Kata i4 could easily be one of your phone choices and serve you well. So that's about it, guys. I've been wanting to make a review video about this phone for a long time. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like this kind of content, please hit the subscribe button and make sure to leave a like on the video. As always, guys, I'll see you on the next one. Peace.